What's up, YouTube fam? It's your favorite girl, Jay Shark, coming back to you with yet another reaction video. Today's video is gonna be a little bit special because I haven't done a reaction to Married with Children in quite some time. So if you have not read the title, I'll let you know that. How long was my eyes closed just now? I feel like they was closed or I feel like they were closed for a long time. But anyway, if you have not read the title, I will let you know I'm going to be reacting to Mr. Al Bundy moments of wisdom, or wisdom, the wisdoms of Al Bundy. I really don't like the way it's titled. So Al Bundy wisdom, that's what we're gonna react to today, okay? So before I get into this video, be sure to hit that subscribe button, tap that notification bell as well, and follow me on Instagram at jshara with an H at the end. Let's get into it.
What's that? It's an anniversary present for my wife.
You gonna get that?
Yeah.
How many years you've been married?
One.
Well, see, that explains it. See, you're obviously new to the married game. Let me help you out. See, the first thing I learned on my 16-year tour of duty was that women live for presents. Now, you take the most ornery woman in the world. We'll call her Peggy. Now, you bring a crappy present home, like that picture frame, and your life will be a living hell.
Well, my wife and I agreed that we wouldn't spend too much on our anniversary.
But
we decided we'd save our money for more important things.
There is no more important thing than your anniversary. See, an anniversary is something special. It's not like other holidays when other people are celebrating too. It's just between the two of you. See, it's a day when you can show how you feel the rest of the year, but you don't, because you're a man.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, to know me is to love me.
I like anniversaries personally, so. What the hell
what
happened?
Is it with you, Bundy? You still not getting enough curb in your diet? I mean, we knock you around, you come back. Why?
Mama didn't raise no.
For the same reason men climb mountains or sail across the sea alone. For the only reason that a rational man would do an irrational thing like
oh,
this.
Oh, God.
Pride.
No, women. I'm a moron, Ray Ray. We're all morons. That's what comes from being a man. From the first little worm they dare us to eat, to the last big shovel full of snow they convince us we can move, we're nothing more to women than an amusement park ride with life insurance.
Well,
that's what we do, the idiotic things that we do. For example, you ski?
No.
Well, you will someday if a girl wants you to. We all will. We'd hurtle down that mountain so fast that the crack of our bodies hitting the tree wouldn't even resonate in their ears before we'd pounce up and say, I'm okay. They know we're not okay. Hell, even if they missed that pair of squirrels running away with our hacky sacks, one glance down at the color of the snow would hint that there might be some trauma. And we've all been to a weight room when a pretty girl walks by and said to ourselves, gee, I think I'll start today's warm-up bench press with, oh, 9 tons. So you see, Ray Ray, as long as there's women, there'll be men around doing stupid things to impress
them.
For
real. Facts.
That's why I'm here. That's why you're here. That's why they're here. Now, someday you may evolve beyond this, but it's too late for me. I'm too old, too married, and lost far too many hacky sacks.
So, it's either I split so you look cool in front of your girl,
or you look cool in front of yours and kill me.
He about to get punched. Looks like a raccoon got a hold of his shirt.
Let's rock.
Not the kisses. Are they about to jump in? Jesus.
Ooh.
Wow. Yeah. Fighting for your property.
I have been in court on 1,000 trumped-up charges. Some real, some imagined. The point is, I lost all of them. I don't know the law, nor do I really know how to pleasure a woman. I have no interest in either. But let me ask you one important question. How did we become a great country? By kicking the hinies of anybody who threatened our borders. And that's what I was doing. I was protecting my border. If a man comes into my house, he better be carrying a summons or a pizza. But this man wasn't, so I called in the Marines and the 51st Airborne. So in conclusion, Your Honor, if you rule against me, you rule against every man who fought for his country. Yeah. Yeah. The boys at San Juan Hill, the boys at Iwo Jima, Audie Murphy, Eddie Murphy, Murphy Brown.
Whoever.
Brown and serve sausage. The cheap brown shoes that every working man is proud to use to kick the hiney of any man who invades his home.
Yeah. Okay. Oh my goodness.
Now what reeks is this facade that we call Labor Day? Mm. Honk if you hate Labor Day. You know what else reeks? Families reek. Honk if you hate families.
Is he holding up traffic?
Because they are truly the reason Labor Day reeks. Once a year, they're on these highways and byways. What do they say? We hate this. We hate you. Idiot. Moron.
Buffoon daddy.
Buffoon daddy. But what about us? The ones who truly labor. We're on this stinking road every day, choking and wheezing, marching along like lemmings to a horrible screaming death. Mm-hmm. Who cries for us, Argentina? Not our families. Well, we can't expect that. The yoke on the oxen feels no guilt. But what we can expect is that on our one lousy stinking day off, traffic can move us to our lousy stinking pathetic destinations. Our polluted beaches, our burning
that first
forests,
guy was
our
fine
grandmas, to our family barbecues with Uncle Otto and his runny yacht.
I got sidetracked.
But does the highway department prepare for us? Are they out here helping us?
Mm-mm.
Are they out there in front of us by that first damn car that caused this traffic jam saying, step on the gas, you moron! Let the 20 million people pass! They are not. Why? Because they don't care. And that, my friends, is what really reeks.
That's
so let's face it, we're not moving. We're just lining up to die. But let's show them that the American spirit is not dead. So join me, will you, on this, our Labor Day, and get out of your cars and tear this highway to bits. Go into your trunks. Get your tire irons and your road flares. Burn, baby, burn. Vengeance is ours.
How did he even get to that point? I want to see the episode now. Beer and taxes.
Kid's right. Give up. We did.
No, we can't quit.
You say we should try again next year?
No. Tell you the truth, I'm never voting again. Like marriage, no matter who you choose, it turns out bad. Unless you're rich. They get everything they want. Well, fine. Let them have their birds and their air and even their presidents. We cared about beer. And they took it away from us. Yeah, sure, what do they care if a man who sells shoes or fixes cars or totes that barge or spears that duty in the park has to use his whole paycheck to buy one beer?
Mm-hmm.
What do they care?
They're at their outdoor restaurants eating their little pizzas and drinking some fine wine in the no smoking section with their sexy, skinny second wives. But we're breeding with peasant stock. No offense, babe. One thing I know, we're never going to win through the system. Voting has never been the American way. We didn't get away from that pansy country England by voting. We did it by throwing their stinking tea in our American harbor.
Yeah!
And why? Because Americans don't like tea. We like coffee. And Americans don't like wine. We like beer. Yeah. Ice cold.
I don't like coffee or beer.
Best in a bottle, but fine anyway.
But everyone I know does.
And wake up in a pool of a beer. So let's show them how a beer man votes. Let's get the blitz and take it to the streets. Let's strike a blow anywhere they dine al fresco. Anywhere they eat brie cheese. And anywhere they wear their pants up high around their waist in the European way. The only thing that Americans understand is mindless Tom and Jerry cartoon-like violence. So let's go kick some elite butt. Give me beer or give me death.
He's like, it worked.
We're both. Let's pillage.
TV violence.
But our point here is we know where real violence comes from. And it's not from that magic box I like to call TV. Oh, sure, the tube can be blamed for a lot of things. Brent Musburger. Full House.
Love Full House.
Any show where overweight female cops dress up as hookers. But violence? That's too easy. We've all been brought up on Roadrunner cartoons and the Three Stooges. But how many of us have run a saw across a bald guy's head? How many of us have drawn a tunnel on the side of a mountain only to watch our loved ones smash themselves into it?
Right.
And you know why? Because we had parents, ladies and gentlemen. Parents who said, don't do what TV tells you to do. Do what we tell you to do, or it's five across the eyes.
No, seriously.
Anyway, I say if there's a problem with TV today, it's because parents aren't saying that anymore. Take my kids, please. Thanks for the joke, Jefferson.
Kennedy's on the floor.
Kennedy's always on the floor. Anyway, my kids may not be angels, but when they screw up, I don't blame TV. I put the blame squarely where it belongs. On their mother.
Oh, wow.
And rap music.
And rap music.
I like rap music. No.
Typical, they had the black guy say it.
So
I like rap music,
I'd like
too.
To say, the next time you want to find the source of violence, try looking on the other side of the screen.
Right.
Thank you. And God save the queen.
What? Each segment in that video, each portion of that video, he was speaking complete facts. If there's children watching this show, they still have things that you can learn. However, there's still that comedy or comedic aspect to it. I like how they merged that together. I still have not been able to watch a full episode of Married with Children. However, I do enjoy the reactions in the videos that you all recommend regarding Married with Children. So don't hesitate to keep recommending those. And if you have any other videos that you wish for me to react to that are absolutely reaction worthy, don't hesitate to drop those as well. If you have not done so already, be sure to hit that subscribe button as we are on the road to 50,000 subscribers. Tap that notification bell and follow me on Instagram at jshar with an h at the end. You all know that I love you. You love yourself 10 times more. Have a beautiful day or night in this amazing world. Ciao.